Alaskan Bush People, Bush Code, Recap. In the Alaskan Bush People episode, Bush Code, August 9, the Brown children face a critical decision as they part ways with the family's Alaskan homestead. Amy braces for her upcoming cancer treatments in California and the wolf pack finds new ways to keep spirits high. Alaskan Bush People, Weight of the Wolf Pack, Recap. After Matt is injured in an explosion, Bear, Rain and Bird are left to do the difficult work on the homestead. The Bushido Code, or Way of the Warrior, refers to a complex set of japanes. E samurai values stressing honor and loyalty to country and family above all else. In contrast, the Alaskan Bush People episode, Bush Code, is a pointless and tedious hour of television. Let's get this over with. We find the Brownton Abbey mop-up crew of Bear, Rain and Bird enjoying one last blast of the cannon before packing it up. I guess I will never get to see Cannon versus Trebuchet in a shootin' match. The unfortunate and horrifying task of cleaning up nose crap falls on Bear, who has to dispose of various old electronics and animal parts preserved in jars. Bear says that no left an exaggerative EXXXXTREME amount of stuff behind. Bear has never been one to exaggerate anything, ever. Bear, Bird and Rain are left to sort through a lifetime of belongings before leaving the bush for good, says our dear narrator, Asa. A lifetime of belongings. Didn't they lose everything about 3 times in the past 5 years? Blah. Bear releases the family's mechanical bull back into the wild. I wonder if they ever tried to mate it with Sabrina. In California, Billy and Amy are at UCLA's Manoukian Medical Building awaiting Amy's chemo and radiation treatment options. Dr. Anraldo, a radiation oncologist who is just now discovering what an awful show this is, tries to ease Amy and Billy's anxieties. Dr. Raldo explains that some patients grow to like their treatments because it becomes part of their routine. I've been covering this show routinely for over 4 years. It never gets easier. Amy undergoes a CT scan to locate the cancer and determine where to place the TAT. O markings that will help align and focus her radiation treatments. The 15 most awesome Alaskan Bush People characters who aren't Kenny. From insane Dwayne and cowboy Dean to Christy and Mr. Cupcake. Here are the best ABP characters who aren't Kenny. Looks like we're in for yet another Bear intensive episode. Bear wants to drag the wind turbine to the integrity because he's an idiot. Bear actually falls on his face. And I enjoyed that. It seems that Billy's old buddy Trapper is coming in 4 days to take the integrity and all the junk on it to Juneau, where the junk will then be shipped to whatever godforsaken land the Browns turn into their next home. While Bear does the heavy lifting, Birdie and Rainey are busy fulfilling Amy's request for Devil's Club, which sounds like it could be the name of a biker bar, but it's not. It's just a plant. Oplopinax hortus is said to have medicinal properties, and it's also used to ward off evil, so let's see if it keeps Billy away. Being in Brownton Abbey while her mom is sick in California gives Birdie feelings of sadness, which she fights by having feelings of anger. I guess you don't develop emotional maturity or fashion sense by talking to animals. Speaking of immaturity, Matt has his sit-down with Billy to discuss that whole explosion thing. Matt's head is still sore, but it's his pride that hurts most. Billy says the staples in Matt's head are cool. Matt says he frankened himself. You were close, you know that. Billy tells Matt, could have killed you. You could have had brain damage, could have had an excuse for being like you are. Zing. Then Billy offers some great fatherly advice, like I say, do. Like, be a man. Got any other wisdom, Billy? Trapper arrives on the shore of Brownton Abbey.